So do not throw away your boots, especially expensive ones. Hi, this is Dr. Kim. I know this is well overdue that I answer some of these questions on the YouTube channel. So I'm about to answer some of these questions on this video called How to Kill Athlete's Foot Fungus. So first question is from Shy Y. And he or she said, I've had really bad athlete's foot for 5 years, probably longer, and I'm almost 17. Is it too late for me to get it removed or treated? Well, you're 17, so you've had it for a while, but since you're really young, your immune system is robust and really good, and you regenerate skin cells very well, so absolutely no problem getting started now. And you've had it for a while though, so we have to really take a lot of effort to make this better, but we're gonna review some of those through the other questions though. The answer is yes, this is a very good time to get started, and it's never too late, especially if you're only 17. So next question. Aiden O'Toole, can athlete's foot travel through my socks that I wear around the house? Answer is yes. I don't want my family to get my athlete's foot, I don't blame you. I wear sandals around the house always and in the shower. Let my feet air dry. Again, can I get away with wearing socks around the house? Well, yes, that's a good idea to wear socks. However, fungus loves dark and moist area, like inside your socks. So if you're home, I know you're concerned about spreading it to other family members, but it is a great idea for you not to wear socks at home. And then obviously it is very possible that you can spread it to the other members. However, if you clean your feet and keep it dry, and then you do all the things that I'm gonna tell you, then it's really gonna help that you don't spread your fungus to other family members. Very good question though. Next one is Jubair Khan. I've had infected too much now. This time I have wounds between my fingers and also swelling around the fingers. I think you're talking about toes though, by the way. Wounds have also pus in it. What should I do? Please guide me. Well, a lot of these athlete's foot can have this little pustule, we call it. It's got a pus inside. It's from the fungus. So if you have these pustules between the toes, obviously, you may have to pop those pustules, and by soaking it, soften it, and then you may wanna use a needle to get all these. If you have a lot of pus in it, you definitely wanna get rid of the pus from there, okay? But soaking in Epsom salt, tea tree oil, and also baking powder, if you wanna, baking soda, if you put some of that in there, it really kills the fungus very well. You have to do this daily, about 10 to 15 minutes. If you're brave, do it twice a day, then it really would help you quite a bit by soaking your feet. Also, apple cider vinegar, also very, very helpful as well. So you can mix that into the whole mixture of the things that I told you about. Apple cider vinegar, baking soda, and tea tree oil and Epsom salt combination, that really kills the fungus very well. Next question, Amber Maxwell. Is it common for the top of my feet to itch? No, it's not. Also, I have work boots I obviously can't just get rid of. It's over $200 boots. How can I get rid of, get it out of my boots? Well, it's a very expensive boot, by the way, so I don't want fungus in there. However, this is where your fungus lives. They love your shoes. So you have to rotate your shoes. You cannot have same, you cannot wear same shoe 2 days in a row. You rotate the shoes and always use like a tenecteum or antifungal spray into the shoes. You can even leave it outside a little, get a little bit of sun, not too much sun, then it's gonna mess up the whole shoe, right? Especially $200 boots. So it is very important that you rotate your shoes every day. Don't wear same shoe twice, 2 days in a row, and then maybe three pairs, maybe two or three pairs at least, and then spray the antifungal spray, let it rest, let some sun into it, then it would definitely kill your fungus. So do not throw away your boots, especially expensive ones. Next one is King Kang. Just soak your feet with water and vinegar for 10 minutes per foot. No side effects and cheap. Absolutely, you got it right on the head. Apple cider vinegar or white vinegar, very powerful way to kill fungus. But like I said before, you can add some other ingredients like tea tree oil, baking soda, or even Epsom salt also works very well to soak your feet daily. But don't forget, you have to keep the area dry. by wearing no socks in the shoe inside your house. And also you can use a hair dryer after you come out of the shower to dry the area, because fungus loves moisture. If you get rid of the moisture, then fungus cannot live. So it's a very good idea when you come out of the shower to use about 3 minutes or so, use your hair dryer to really dry between the toes and your whole feet, so that it's very powerful way to keep the fungus away. So hope this video really helped you. If you have more questions, please let me know. I'll make more videos like this. Please give thumbs up and then make comments below so I can give you more good videos. Thank you.